create a spirit within the club that you go in. You go in quick, and the spirit becomes almost immediate. How do you go about creating that?
You know, my philosophy is very basic and very simple, but sometimes the basic and the simple is not easy to get. The most important thing in the club are players, team, and we work for them. And we all in the club, we have to be organized in a way where they are in the best possible conditions to express themselves on the pitch. So what do they need? They need good coaching. They need good facilities. They need good medical department. They need good everything around them. And this is a part of my job I must
You're selling yourself short a little bit, because I've spoken to Frank in depth about you, and you're very personal with the players as well. And you've got a personal touch. You'll call players when they need it.
No, you know, we are all different.
Do you treat people differently? Do you look at their personalities and say, you know, I can't shout at him?
I treat my kids differently.
I have to take this one like this?
And the point is, they are different. They react in a different way to different situations and to different feedbacks. And the better I know them, the better I can interact with them. Mm-hmm. It's so simple as this. Me and my wife, we discuss a lot about this in relation to our kids. Our kids, same father, same mother, same blood, same environment. They are so different.
For you, what is the biggest achievement in your football career as a manager?
You know, I feel that one was a big achievement for me, which was to arrive where I arrive as a manager when I was not a top player. I think in this moment, football world is changed. In this moment, the football world understands that this is possible. I was one of the responsibles for this change of mentality for the new generations, because in my time, 15, 20 years ago, even when I started as an assistant, was a situation difficult to beat.
Do you have any big regrets in management? What's your biggest regret? You think, oh, I shouldn't have done that. I could have done that better.
That's not part of my...
You look forward.
Yeah, that's not part of my personality. I'm not. I can cry because I win in some important moment. I cannot cry because I lose. You know, I remember clearly, because in my first year in Inter, we were knocked out of the Champions League at Old Trafford. We lost against you 2-0. And I remember clearly that people was so disappointing in the dressing room, because it was one more year of the typical frustration. And I was in the corridor in front of the referee's
changing room.
And I got the president, Moratti. We need this to go, this to come, and next season we can. So even in a dark moment of our life,
you're thinking ahead.
I was ahead. If I win, I can be emotional. I can feel it deeply. But if I lose, I want more.
But again, like I've seen you win, even in Chelsea, when you won the league, you give your medal to the fans. I saw that. It seems like you win, and then you're bang, another, this is the next goal, that's the next goal. Is that how you are, or is that just outside for the bravado?
Yeah, I always say that I don't like very much to celebrate the title, a lot, because it's not the last. Yeah. One day will be the last, and I don't celebrate the last. but that's my feeling. I don't celebrate a lot because this is not the last one.